I'm Melina McDonald and welcome to Human Design. I'm super excited today so I can introduce some of you to what human design is and how it actually works. So have any of you ever heard of the Myers-Briggs personality test, the 16 personalities, the disc profile, the enneagrams, you know, people doing your astrology charts? Well, let's just say human design is all of that on steroids, seriously. I mean, I know for me personally, I've always sat there going, oh my God, wouldn't it be great if when we've got children and we give birth to them, they come out with their own little manual, sort of like going to IKEA and you've got your flat pack, but you don't have the actual instruction manual of how to put it together. So everything gets a little bit confusing. Or you've actually done, like you're going along in life and things are pretty good and you're finding that, you know, life's worked out well with business and love, but you feel like there's something that's missing. You know, it's like, I know I can get more from life and I can get more success or more love or, you know, whatever it is for you. Human design, basically by taking some simple information on your birthday, okay, so your birth name, your place of birth, and it has to be the exact spelling of your name on your birth certificate, not the other names that maybe you call yourself, but your name, your birth date, your location of birth, and your time of birth. We're actually from there able to work out who you are. So human design is a blueprint manual of who you are. It explains so many things. I mean, I'm not kidding you, there are so many layers. We can work out how your energy works, how it affects those people that are around you, how you are supposed to make decisions for you. In addition to that, I mean, here's the deal. We sit there and everybody tells us to be like this, dress like this, act like this, eat like this, and you know, just go out and do it. You know, manifest, you can manifest everything, and that is completely incorrect. There is over 69,000 different points of reference that come in that is possible to create you. So if there's that many to have those components come in, then, and let's say that you've only got 26 of those is activated, you know, why is it that I'm supposed to behave like the person next to me? So we look at, you know, where you put weight on, why you put weight on in certain areas. We can look at business. We can look at, you know, what kind of environment are you supposed to live in? What are you maybe supposed to eat? How do you love? How do you feel? So human design is about everything. It's about seeing you. It's about being seen for the first time, about who you actually are, underneath all the masks that come from society, your parents' beliefs, you know, the schooling and teaching and you know, any instructors that you've had, and the things that we are taught every single day of how we're supposed to be. But the reality is that's not you. You are living someone else's life, okay? So with this blueprint, we get this information, and there's a few different ways we can do it. We've got some that just want to understand how your energy and aura works and how you are supposed to make decisions for you, because there's quite a few different variations. So for myself, I have my sacral's activated, and with that, that's about the energy that I need to use my intuition. So one of the common themes we specifically with women say is women's intuition, and that's quite incorrect, because not every woman is supposed to use her intuition to make decisions. Okay, only about 50 something percent of the population actually should be using their intuition. Other ways it could be you need to have a sounding board, or when you speak out loud you hear truth, or you're supposed to feel it emotionally in your body. So there's all different ways, you know, for you to make your decision. So a lot of people will tend to start with working out, what am I? Am I a generator? Am I a manifestor, or a manifesting generator, a projector, or a reflector? And how am I supposed to make, you know, my decisions? And we start you off there. We can also see what your purpose is in this lifetime. You know, that we can work out what your profile is. So, you know, pretty much what I'm going to do is I'm going to do another video and I'm going to show you a chart and we're going to work on my chart and I'm going to go through it and I'm going to explain how it actually works. But pretty much there's five different kinds of beings, but then there's all unique components that come in to make you. So what I'm here to do, and I do specialize in love and relationships, okay, and intimacy. That is my background. I've tried one of everything, and when I got my human design chart done, it blew my mind. I actually cried through most of my reading because I was being seen for the things that at this stage of my life I was thinking, I think this is really me, that this other stuff isn't really me, but this is the real me that was, and it was actually sitting underneath and it was true. So it's helped me make better decisions with life, love, money, you name it, in every component of my life. And what I want to do is make sure that I can do this for you. So I'm going to do a whole bunch of videos explaining some of the different types and giving you a couple little hints and tips so that way you understand a little bit more about human design. It is actually six modalities that have been brought together. I had to think for a second. So there's everything from the I Ching to the Kabbalah to the hexagrams, Eastern and Western astrology, and there's a few other modalities thrown in there. So, you know, you've got heaps and heaps of different modalities that come together, which is why we call it it's like astrology on steroids. So I want to actually assist you guys as much as possible to find out how you tick and help get back to you.